was not able to walk, or breathe, or eat. My breath was made of stone, and my body of water. And yet, I was dying of thirst. I lived in cities most of the time. And while I led a public life, I was attracted to the law. I liked crowds. As nobody, I was sovereign. But one day, I grew tired of being the stone that beats solitary men to death. I am the first among urbanists, but the relation of the city for me is immediately a relation to politics. Politics is first and foremost the polis, and the city is primarily war. Traveling was no longer more than a fantasy. All that was real. Take note. I nearly lost my sight because someone crushed glass in my eyes. I had the feeling I was going back into the wall. Freedom needs a fear. The feel of freedom is shrinking. The worst thing was the sudden, shocking cruelty of the day. I could not look, but I could not help looking. To see was terrifying, and to stop seeing tore me apart from my forehead to my throat. The missiles go by themselves. We are finished! And once more, I heard hyena cries that exposed me to the threat of a wild animal.
These people were approaching from everywhere, coming.
was not in the sky. The sky is clean and blue. Yes, definitely golden color. No, no, I know. Because the window was open, just above me. Only then, from far away, something was bumping, coming closer. I had to go out through the window for scuffling or smelling such a noise. And all these people then coming, opening their mouths as wanting to say something as if I had done something to them. What were they afraid to say? The bumping stopped. And now they were screaming, accident! Accident! I could not see why. They said I crashed. But no.
You accept your difficulties very complacently. You astonish me.